One of the things that caught our attention was that she managed to get a Botox treatment while in prison in Mexico City.
What?
They say he one of them ghetto boys in the Bushwick. That's a mentality that keep niggas sick. Come on, dog. You think you're a pit? You meant to grow here, and that's what you pick? Don't worry about me, nigga. See, that is your problem. You always run to your mouth. Remember when mom had that electric problem? Did you help her out? DeJuan died, nigga. Doody died, nigga. Quincy died, nigga. Debo died, and you could have been with him if you didn't make it out that job. I remember when you.
What it do? It's your boy Chimmy the General Man, and we back with another video. Let's go.
My nigga.
Man, you already know what time it is, man. We got Sandra Avila by Tron, Queens of Queens by Los Tigres. Las Tigueres del Norte and Los Ticanes de Tijuana. Los Ticanes de Tijuana. Yeah, man. Make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe. Make sure you follow me on what, man? Instagram and all that, man. Y'all know what time it is, man. It's time to get to it. You dig? In Mexico, a queen allegedly rose to kingpin. Mexico City blessed with charm and good looks, Sandra Avila Patron is enthralling Mexico, not as a beautiful queen, but as an alleged drug lord. And the story of her arrest and possibly extradition to the U.S. is being followed more closely than a telenovela. Police say the raven-haired 46-year-old spent more than a decade working her way to the top. Colones of Mexico? I don't know how to pronounce it. Y'all let me know. Okay, let me make sure where I'm at. A Mexico males dominated drug trade, united Colombian and Mexican gangs, and seducing several notorious kingpins. Wow. Dubbed by Queens of the Pacific, she even has her own song. A folk ballad about drug traffickers by Los Tucanes de Tijuana that pays homage to her as a top lady who is a key part of the business. Man. It's like the front of Sandra Avila Patron's home. It's an altar and lit candles that form a crowned shrine to her first husband. Riddled by gunfire, her second husband stabbed through the heart, and her brother tortured to death. What in the world is going on? All were murdered. That's all. We are wildin'. Government, I ain't murdered nobody, I promise. Y'all niggas not meaning me. Yeah. All were murdered during Mexico ongoing cocaine wars. Wow. Gunfire, stabbed. Torture. This is crazy. Avila is the stuff legends are made of. One of the few women, not just men out here, women, with access to high levels of cartel life. She has lived, worked, and loved inside the upper echelons. Echelones or something? That's how you say it? Yeah, let me know. A Mexican drug war since the late 1970s at the height of her career. She showed a propensity to carry suitcases with millions of dollars in crisp hundred bills. Let's keep going, bro. Let's keep going. Yeah, this.
Her name is Sandra Avila Beltran. She's accused of trying to smuggle cocaine to the United States and is facing extradition.
Her name is Sandra Avila Beltran, and she may be the most infamous.
What's it? Oh, man. Come on, man. This is making me mad. On September 28, 2007, more than 30 Mexican federal agents swarmed into a diner where Sandra Villa Beltran was having coffee and arrested her. She coolly asked the agents to let her freshen her makeup before the police filmed her transfer to jail. They let her do it? But why is they not letting me click the space bar? Listen, bro. That's why I'm picky with what women I choose to. Like, all women can't mess with me. You know what I'm saying? Y'all think, oh, she beautiful. Nigga, some of y'all niggas will smash anything. And that's how y'all get killed. Y'all think, oh, this is going to be a good night. It is. When the cops come in here, you got a knife in your stomach. Knife in your heart. Y'all think everything good, or you take a girl home, next thing you know, you didn't know it was dudes following behind you. You just thought you was having a good night, huh? All right. Especially somebody like her. Queen of the queens. She said, nah. Yes, every criminal gotta move very cautiously. Like, yo. She was arrested with her lover, Juan Diego Espinosa Ramirez, alias the Tiger, who is said to be an important figure in the Colombia Norte del Valle Cartel. Wow. I like how they say a queen with a smile, and they don't really see her smiling right here. It's just like, you know, I get you, right? Like, it ain't even like, it's like. But neither can match Sandra. Exposed to violence from a young age, Avila witnessed her first shootout at the age of 13. And y'all wonder why people crazy. I'll be like, oh my God, they're crazy. I'm sure you know what they went through as a kid. Shootout at 13? She witnessed? And I ain't witnessed mine till like, man, probably high school. Mine's just probably like 15, 16. They shot at us. But anyway, let's keep going. It was later and the tip was made on her own, like. She left and see. Oh, so it was in 2007. In September 2007, Avila was finally arrested and sentenced to 10 years in prison. And she definitely don't care. Look at her face. That's what I'm talking about. Life is chess, not checkers. You make one mistake and it's checkmate. Like I had one of my young homies, he messed with this girl. He thought, oh, everything good. Long story short, she got to his social, his bank account, nigga, everything. You know what I'm saying? It got wicked. Like, how you let a girl get that close? Don't never let her get that close, boys. What else? And everybody. Seized from a December 2001 drug bust linked to Sandra and her lover. Authorities seized the tuna boat, the Marseille, in the port of Mazananillo, Mexico, and found more than 9 tons of cocaine aboard, worth 80 mil at the time. It was the largest seize recorded by the DEA. This credo was released in 2004, 3 years before Sandra's arrest. A party was held in the mountains to celebrate Arturo Beltran Leva. When Sandra makes an unexpected arrival confirmed by her to journalist Julio Scrutcher, El Chapo Guzman was among the guests. Confused, a lady could run it if she wants to, because some of y'all niggas is weak. You know what I mean? Some of y'all niggas will let a woman do anything, let her talk to you any type of way, let her smack you around, and you'd be like, yes, ma'am, goofy boy. So, it,
one of the most notorious figures in the Mexican drug cartel universe about to be set free. This is from an American jail. She is a woman is so notorious, people know her better by her nickname, Queen of the Pacific.
Well, after her arrest in 2007 in Mexico City, one of the things that caught our attention was that she managed to get a Botox treatment while in prison in Mexico City.
What?
A bordo bordo de una camioneta blanca y con el rostro cubierto, abandonó el penal federal El Rincón de Tepic, Nayarit. Tras 8 años presa, confirmó la liberación de Sandra Ávila Beltrán, asegurando...
I'm not reading all this, I ain't gonna lie. I read the beginning. Man, see how they show all nothing but dudes? Like, if she ran with, you know what I'm saying? Like, her competition with some of these dudes. You know what I'm saying? Well, most dudes, because she was an old woman. Okay, let's see. For her son's 15th birthday, she gave him a Hummer, and later a $40,000 allowance every few months. From her neck hung a golden pendant in the form of now y'all trying to get me, to tank human with 83 rubies, 228 diamonds, and 189 Shipies? Shipires. Sapphires. Photos of her party life resemble an episode of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, except when they scan the photos every few years, another one of her characters have been murdered. She, however, saved invincible. Shout out to the OGs, man. Los Tigres del Norte. And Los Tucanes de Tijuana. Shout out to Corrido Fouls. This your boy Chip the General, man. Y'all let me know what y'all think about this. What y'all think about Sandra Avila Beltran, and what y'all know about the Queen of the Pacific. The Queen of the Pacific. Y'all let me know. Make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram. And it's time to go. Yeah, dick. Yeah.
Figured out she was playing board games on my chest. I feel sorry, sight. I don't care if she was in trouble, pipe. Saying yes, she loved a tan. Lying said she loved a man. Her name should be Spider because she loved a win. Had me guessing from the top of my dome like headbands. Everything was really good, I thought we really had a plan.